The Diatessaron. A Harmony of the Four Gospels. Compiled by Tatian of Adiabene. Podcast 3 of 6. Chapter 18. At that time Herod the Tetrarch heard of the fame of Jesus, and all the things which came to pass at his hand, and he marveled, for he had obtained excellent information concerning him. And same men said that John the Baptist was risen from among the dead, and others said that Elijah had appeared, and others, Jeremiah, and others, that a prophet of the old prophets was risen, and others said that he was a prophet like one of the prophets. Herod said to his servants, "This is John the Baptist, he whom I beheaded, he is risen from among the dead, therefore mighty works result from him." For Herod himself had sent and taken John, and cast him into prison, for the sake of Herodias his brother Philip's wife, whom he had taken. And John said to Herod, "Thou hast no authority to take the wife of thy brother." And Herodias avoided him and wished to kill him, and she could not. But Herod feared John, for he knew that he was a righteous man and a holy, and he guarded him, and heard him much, and did, and obeyed him with gladness. And he wished to kill him, but he feared the people, for they adhered to him as the prophet. And there was a celebrated day, and Herod had made a feast for his great men on the day of his anniversary, and for the officers and for the chief men of Galilee. And the daughter of Herodias came in and danced in the midst of the company, and pleased Herod and those that sat with him. And the king said to the damsel, "Ask of me what thou wilt, and I will give it thee." And he sware unto her, "Whatsoever thou shalt ask, I will give it thee, to the half of my kingdom." And she went out, and said unto her mother, "What shall I ask him?" She said unto her, "The head of John the Baptist." And immediately she came in hastily to the king, and said unto him, "I desire in this hour that thou give me on a dish the head of John the Baptist." And the king was exceeding sorry, but because of the oath and the guests he did not wish to refuse her. But immediately the king sent an executioner, and commanded that he should bring the head of John, and he went and cut off the head of John in the prison, and brought it on a dish, and delivered it to the damsel, and the damsel gave it to her mother. And his disciples heard, and came, and took his body, and buried it. And they came and told Jesus what had happened. And for this cause Herod said, "I beheaded John, who is this, of whom I hear these things?" And he desired to see him. And Jesus, when he heard, removed thence in a boat to a waste place alone, to the other side of the sea of the Galilee of Tiberias. And many saw them going, and knew them, and hastened by land from all the cities, and came thither beforehand, for they saw the signs which he was doing on the sick. And Jesus went up into the mountain, and sat there with his disciples. And the feast of the Passover of the Jews was near. And Jesus lifted up his eyes, and saw great multitudes coming to him. And he was moved with compassion for them, for they were like sheep that were without a shepherd. And he received them, and spake to them concerning the kingdom of God, and healed those who had need of healing. And when the evening approached, his disciples came to him, and said unto him, "The place is desert, and the time is past, send away the multitudes of the people, that they may go to the towns and villages which are around us, and buy for themselves bread, for they have nothing to eat." But he said unto them, "They have no need to go away, give ye them what may be eaten." They said unto him, "We have not here enough." He said unto Philip, "Whence shall we buy bread that these may eat?" And he said that proving him, and he knew what he was resolved to do. Philip said unto him, 200 penny worth of bread would not suffice them after every one of them hath taken a small amount." One of his disciples said unto him, namely, Andrew the brother of Simon Peter, "Here is a lad having 5 loaves of barley and 2 fishes, but this amount, what is it for all these? But wilt thou that we go and buy for all the people what may be eaten? For we have no more than these 5 loaves and the 2 fishes." And the grass was plentiful in that place. Jesus said unto them, "Arrange all the people that they may sit down on the grass, 50 people in a company." And the disciples did so. And all the people sat down by companies, by hundreds, and fifties. Then Jesus said unto them, Bring hither those 5 loaves and the 2 fishes. And when they brought him that, Jesus took the bread and the fish, and looked to heaven, and blessed, and divided, and gave to his disciples to set before them, and the disciples set for the multitudes the bread and the fish, and they ate, all of them, and were satisfied. And when they were satisfied, he said unto his disciples, Gather the fragments that remain over, that nothing be lost. And they gathered, and filled 12 baskets with fragments, being those that remained over from those which ate of the 5 barley loaves and the 2 fishes. And those people who ate were 5,000, besides the women and children. And straightway he pressed his disciples to go up into the ship, and that they should go before him unto the other side to Bethsaida, while he himself should send away the multitudes. And those people who saw the sign which Jesus did, said, Of a truth this is a prophet who hath come into the world. And Jesus knew their purpose to come and take him, and make him a king, and he left them, and went up into the mountain alone for prayer. And when the nightfall was near, his disciples went down unto the sea, and sat in a boat, and came to the side of Capernaum. And the darkness came on, and Jesus had not come to them. And the sea was stirred up against them by reason of a violent wind that blew. And the boat was distant from the land many furlongs, and they were much damaged by the waves, and the wind was against them. Chapter 19. And in the fourth watch of the night Jesus came unto them, walking upon the water, after they had rowed with difficulty about 25 or 30 furlongs. And when he drew near unto their boat, his disciples saw him walking on the water, and they were troubled, and supposed that it was a false appearance, and they cried out from their fear. But Jesus straightway spoke unto them, and said, Take courage, for it is I, fear not. Then Peter answered and said unto him, My Lord, if it be thou, bid me to come unto thee on the water. And Jesus said unto him, Come. And Peter went down out of the boat, and walked on the water to come unto Jesus. But when he saw the wind strong, he feared, and was on the point of sinking, and he lifted up his voice, and said, My Lord, save me. And immediately our Lord stretched out his hand and took hold of him, and said unto him, Thou of little faith, why didst thou doubt? And when Jesus came near, he went up unto them into the boat, he and Simon, and immediately the wind ceased. And those that were in the ship came and worshipped him, and said, Truly thou art the Son of God. And straightway that ship arrived at the land which they made for. And when they came out of the ship to the land, they marveled greatly and were perplexed in themselves, and they had not understood by means of that bread, because their heart was gross. And when the people of that region knew of the arrival of Jesus, they made haste in all that land, and began to bring those that were diseased, born in their beds to the place where they heard that he was. And wheresoever the place might be which he entered, of the villages or the cities, they laid the sick in the markets, and sought of him that they might touch were it only the edge of his garment, and all that touched him were healed and lived. And on the day after that, the multitude which was standing on the shore of the sea saw that there was there no other ship save that into which the disciples had gone up, and that Jesus went not up into the ship with his disciples, but there were other ships from Tiberias near the place where they ate the bread when Jesus blessed it. And when that multitude saw that Jesus was not there, nor yet his disciples, they went up into those ships, and came to Capernaum, and sought Jesus. And when they found him on the other side of the sea, they said unto him, Our Master, when camest thou hither? Jesus answered and said unto them, Verily, verily, I say unto you, ye have not sought me because of your seeing the signs, but because of your eating the bread and being satisfied. Serve not the food which perisheth, but the food which abideth in eternal life, which the Son of Man will give unto you, him hath God the Father sealed. They said unto him, What shall we do that we may work the work of God? Jesus answered and said unto them, This is the work of God, that ye believe in him whom he hath sent. They said unto him, What sign hast thou done, that we may see, and believe in thee? What hast thou wrought? Our fathers ate the manna in the wilderness, as it was written, Bread from heaven gave he them to eat. Jesus said unto them, Verily, verily, I say unto you, Moses gave you not bread from heaven, but my Father gave you the bread of truth from heaven. The bread of God is that which came down from heaven and gave the world life. They said unto him, Our Lord, give us at all times this bread. Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life, whosoever cometh unto me shall not hunger, and whosoever believeth in me shall not thirst forever. But I said unto you, Ye have seen me, and have not believed. And all that my Father hath given to me cometh unto me, and whosoever cometh unto me I shall not cast him forth without. I came down from heaven, not to do my own will, but to do the will of him that sent me, and this is the will of him that sent me, that I should lose nothing of that which he gave me, but raise it up in the last day. This is the will of my Father, that every one that seeth the Son, and believeth in him, should have eternal life, and I will raise him up in the last day. The Jews therefore murmured against him because of his saying, I am the bread which came down from heaven. And they said, Is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? Then how saith this man, I came down from heaven? Jesus answered and said unto them, Murmur not one with another. No man is able to come unto me, except the Father which sent me draw him, and I will raise him up in the last day. It is written in the prophet, They shall all be the taught of God. Every one who heareth from the Father now, and learneth of him, cometh unto me. No man now seeth the Father, but he that is from God, he it is that seeth the Father. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever believeth in me hath eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness, and they died. This is the bread which came down from heaven, that a man may eat of it, and not die. I am the bread of life which came down from heaven, and if a man eat of this bread he shall live forever, and the bread which I shall give is my body, which I give for the life of the world. The Jews therefore quarreled one with another, and said, How can he give us his body that we may eat it? Jesus said unto them, Verily, verily, I say unto you, If ye do not eat the body of the Son of Man and drink his blood, ye shall not have life in yourselves. Whosoever eateth of my body and drinketh of my blood hath eternal life, and I will raise him up in the last day. My body truly is meat, and my blood truly is drink. Whosoever eateth my body and drinketh my blood abideth in me, and I in him as the living Father sent me, and I am alive because of the Father, and whosoever eateth me, he also shall live because of me. This is the bread which came down from heaven, and not according as your fathers ate the manna, and died, whosoever eateth of this bread shall live forever. This he said in the synagogue, when he was teaching in Capernaum. And many of his disciples, when they heard, said, This word is hard, who is he that can hear it? Chapter 20. And Jesus knew within himself that his disciples were murmuring because of that, and he said unto them, Doth this trouble you? What if ye should see the Son of Man then ascend to the place where he was of old? It is the Spirit that quickeneth, and the body profiteth nothing, the words that I speak unto you are spirit and life. But there are some of you that do not believe. And Jesus knew beforehand who they were who should not believe, and who it was that should betray him. And he said unto them, Therefore I said unto you, No man can come unto me, if that hath not been given him by the Father. And because of this word many of his disciples turned back and walked not with him. And Jesus said unto the 12, Do ye haply also wish to go away? Simon Peter answered and said, My Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life. And we have believed and known that thou art the Messiah, the Son of the living God. Jesus said unto them, Did not I choose you, ye company of the 12, and of you one is a devil? He said that because of Judas the son of Simon Iscariot, for he, being of the 12, was purposed to betray him. And while he was speaking, one of the Pharisees came asking of him that he would eat with him, and he went in, and reclined to meat. And that Pharisee, when he saw it, marveled that he had not first cleansed himself before his eating. Jesus said unto him, Now do ye Pharisees wash the outside of the cup and the dish, and ye think that ye are cleansed, but your inside is full of injustice and wickedness. Ye of little mind, did not he that made the outside make the inside? Now give what ye have in alms, and everything shall be clean unto you. And there came to him Pharisees and scribes, come from Jerusalem. And when they saw some of his disciples eating bread while they had not washed their hands, they found fault. For all of the Jews and the Pharisees, if they wash not their hands thoroughly, eat not, for they held to the ordinance of the elders. And they ate not what was bought from the market, except they washed it, and many other things did they keep of what they had received, such as the washing of cups and measures and vessels of brass, and couches. And scribes and Pharisees asked him, Why do thy disciples not walk according to the ordinances of the elders, but eat bread without washing their hands? Jesus answered and said unto them, Why do ye also overstep the command of God by reason of your ordinance? God said, Honor thy father and thy mother, and, whosoever reviles his father and his mother shall surely die. But ye say, If a man say to his father or to his mother, What thou receivest from me is an offering, and ye suffer him not to do anything for his father or his mother, and ye make void and reject the word of God by reason of the ordinance that ye have ordained and commanded, such as the washing of cups and measures, and what resembles that ye do much. And ye forsook the command of God, and held to the ordinance of men. Do ye well to wrong the command of God in order that ye may establish your ordinance? Ye hypocrites, well did Isaiah the prophet prophesy concerning you, and say, This people honoureth me with its lips, but their heart is very far from me. But in vain do they fear me, in that they teach the commands of men. And Jesus called all the multitude, and said unto them, Hear me, all of you, and understand, nothing without the man, which then enters him, is able to defile him, but what goeth out of him, that it is which defileth the man. He that hath ears that hear, let him hear. Then his disciples drew near, and said unto him, Knowest thou that the Pharisees which heard this word were angry? He answered and said unto them, Every plant which my Father which is in heaven planted not shall be uprooted. Let them alone, for they are blind leading blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both of them shall fall into a hollow. And when Jesus entered the house from the multitude, Simon Peter asked him, and said unto him, My Lord, explain to us that parable. He said unto them, Do ye also thus not understand? Know ye not that everything that entereth into the man from without cannot defile him, because it entereth not into his heart, it entereth into his stomach only, and thence is cast forth in the cleansing which maketh clean all the food? The thing which goeth forth from the mouth of the man proceedeth from his heart, and it is that which defileth the man. From within the heart of men proceed evil thoughts, fornication, adultery, theft, false witness, murder, injustice, wickedness, deceit, stupidity, evil eye, calumny, pride, foolishness. These evils all of them from within proceed from the heart, and they are the things which defile the man, but if a man eat while he washeth not his hands, he is not defiled. And Jesus went out thence, and came to the borders of Tyre and Sidon. And he entered into a certain house, and desired that no man should know it, and he could not be hid. But straightway a Canaanitish woman, whose daughter had an unclean spirit, heard of him. And that woman was a Gentile of Emesa of Syria. And she came out after him, crying out, and saying, Have mercy upon me, my Lord, thou son of David, for my daughter is seized in an evil way by Satan. And he answered her not a word. And his disciples came and besought him, and said, Send her away, for she crieth after us. He answered and said unto them, I was not sent except to the sheep that are gone astray of the house of Israel. But she came and worshipped him, and said, My Lord, help me, have mercy upon me. Jesus said unto her, It is not seemly that the children's bread should be taken and thrown to the dogs. But she said, Yea, my Lord, the dogs also eat of the crumbs that fall from their master's tables, and live. Then said Jesus unto her, O woman, Great is thy faith, it shall be unto thee as thou hast desired. Go then thy way, and because of this word, the devil is gone out of thy daughter. And her daughter was healed in that hour. And that woman went away to her house, and found her daughter laid upon the bed, and the devil gone out of her. Chapter 21. And Jesus went out again from the borders of Tyre and Sidon, and came to the Sea of Galilee, towards the borders of Decapolis. And they brought unto him one dumb and deaf, and entreated him that he would lay his hand upon him and heal him. And he drew him away from the multitude, and went away alone, and spat upon his fingers, and thrust them into his ears, and touched his tongue, and looked to heaven, and sighed, and said unto him, Be opened. And in that hour his ears were opened, and the bond of his tongue was loosed, and he spake with ease. And Jesus charged them much that they should not tell this to any man, but the more he charged them, the more they increased in publishing, and marveled much, and said, This man doth everything well, he made the deaf to hear, and those that lack speech to speak. And while he was passing through the land of Samaria, he came to one of the cities of the Samaritans, called Sychar, beside the field which Jacob gave to Joseph to his son. And there was there a spring of water of Jacob's. And Jesus was fatigued from the exertion of the way, and sat at the spring. And the time was about the sixth hour. And a woman of Samaria came to draw water, and Jesus said unto her, Give me water, that I may drink. And his disciples had entered into the city to buy for themselves food. And that Samaritan woman said unto him, How dost thou, being a Jew, ask me to give thee to drink, while I am a Samaritan woman? And the Jews mingle not with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said unto her, If thou knewest the gift of God, and who this is that said unto thee, Give me to drink, thou wouldest ask him, and he would give thee the water of life. That woman said unto him, My Lord, thou hast no bucket, and the well is deep, from whence hast thou the water of life? Can it be that thou art greater than our father Jacob, who gave us this well, and drank from it, and his children, and his sheep? Jesus answered and said unto her, Every one that drinketh of this water shall thirst again, but whosoever drinketh of the water which I shall give him shall not thirst forever, but the water which I shall give him shall be in him a spring of water springing up unto eternal life. That woman said unto him, My Lord, give me of this water, that I may not thirst again, neither come and draw water from here. Jesus said unto her, Go and call thy husband, and come hither. She said unto him, I have no husband. Jesus said unto her, Thou saidst well, I have no husband, five husbands hast thou had, and this man whom thou hast now is not thy husband, and in this thou saidst truly. That woman said unto him, My Lord, I perceive thee to be a prophet. Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place in which worship must be. Jesus said unto her, Woman, believe me, an hour cometh, when neither in this mountain, nor yet in Jerusalem, shall ye worship the Father. Ye worship that which ye know not, but we worship that which we know, for salvation is of the Jews. But an hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and truth, and the Father also seeketh such as these worshippers. For God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. That woman said unto him, I know that the Messiah cometh, and when he is come, he will teach us everything. Jesus said unto her, I that speak unto thee am he. And while he was speaking, his disciples came, and they wondered how he would speak with a woman, but not one of them said unto him, What seekest thou? Or, what speakest thou with her? And the woman left her water pot, and went to the city, and said to the people, Come, and see a man who told me all that ever I did, perhaps then he is the Messiah. And people went out from the city, and came to him. And in the meanwhile his disciples besought him, and said unto him, Our Master, eat. And he said unto them, I have food to eat that ye know not. And the disciples said amongst themselves, Can any one have brought him aught to eat? Jesus said unto them, My food is to do the will of him that sent me, and to accomplish his work. Said ye not that after 4 months cometh the harvest? Behold, I therefore say unto you, lift up your eyes, and behold the lands, that they have become white, and the harvest is already come. And he that reapeth receiveth his wages, and gathereth the fruit of eternal life, and the sower and the reaper rejoice together. For in this is found the word of truth, one soweth, and another reapeth. And I sent you to reap that in which ye have not laboured, others laboured, and ye have entered on their labour. And from that city many of the Samaritans believed in him because of the words of that woman, who testified and said, He told me all that ever I did. And when those Samaritans came unto him, they besought him to abide with them, and he abode with them 2 days. And many believed in him because of his word, and they said to that woman, Now not because of thy saying have we believed in him, we have heard and known that this truly is the Messiah, the Savior of the world. And after 2 days Jesus went out thence and departed to Galilee. And Jesus testified that a prophet is not honored in his own city. And when he came to Galilee, the Galileans received him. Chapter 22. And when Jesus came to a certain village, there drew near to him a leper, and fell at his feet, and besought him, and said unto him, If thou wilt, thou art able to cleanse me. And Jesus had mercy upon him, and stretched forth his hand, and touched him, and said, I will cleanse thee. And immediately his leprosy departed from him, and he was cleansed. And he sternly charged him, and sent him out, and said unto him, See that thou tell not any man, but go and shew thyself to the priests, and offer an offering for thy cleansing as Moses commanded for their testimony. But he, when he went out, began to publish much, and spread abroad the news, so that Jesus could not enter into any of the cities openly, for the extent to which the report of him spread, but he remained without in a desert place. And much people came unto him from one place and another, to hear his word, and that they might be healed of their pains. And he used to withdraw from them into the desert, and pray. And after that, was the feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. And there was in Jerusalem a place prepared for bathing, which was called in Hebrew the House of Mercy, having 5 porches. And there were laid in them much people of the sick, and blind, and lame, and paralyzed, waiting for the moving of the water. And the angel from time to time went down into the place of bathing, and moved the water, and the first that went down after the moving of the water, every pain that he had was healed. And a man was there who had a disease for 38 years. And Jesus saw this man laid, and knew that he had been thus a long time, and he said unto him, Wouldest thou be made whole? That diseased one answered and said, Yea, my Lord, I have no man, when the water moveth, to put me into the bathing place, but when I come, another goeth down before me. Jesus said unto him, Rise, take thy bed, and walk. And immediately that man was healed, and he rose, and carried his bed, and walked. And that day was a Sabbath. And when the Jews saw that healed one, they said unto him, It is a Sabbath, thou hast no authority to carry thy bed. And he answered and said unto them, He that made me whole, the same said unto me, Take thy bed, and walk. They asked him therefore, Who is this man that said unto thee, Take thy bed, and walk? But he that was healed knew not who it was, for Jesus had removed from that place to another, because of the press of the great multitude which was in that place. And after 2 days Jesus happened upon him in the temple, and said unto him, Behold, thou art whole, sin not again, lest there come upon thee what is worse than the first. And that man went, and said to the Jews that it was Jesus that had healed him. And because of that the Jews persecuted Jesus and sought to kill him, because he was doing this on the Sabbath. And Jesus said unto them, My Father worketh until now, and I also work. And because of this especially the Jews sought to kill him, not because he profaned the Sabbath only, but for his saying also that God was his Father, and his making himself equal with God. Jesus answered and said unto them, Verily, verily, I say unto you, the Son cannot do anything of himself, but what he seeth the Father do, What the Father doth, that the Son also doth like him. The Father loveth his Son, and everything that he doth he sheweth him, and more than these works will he shew him, that ye may marvel. And as the Father raiseth the dead and giveth them life, so the Son also giveth life to whomsoever he will. And the Father judgeth no man, but hath given all judgment unto the Son, that every man may honour the Son, as he honoureth the Father. And he that honoureth not the Son honoureth not the Father which sent him. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever heareth my word, and believeth in him that sent me, hath eternal life, and cometh not into judgment, but passeth from death unto life. Verily, verily, I say unto you, an hour shall come, and now is also, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and those which hear shall live. And as the Father hath life in himself, likewise he gave to the Son also that he might have life in himself, and authority to do judgment also, because he is the Son of Man. Marvel not then at that, I mean the coming of the hour when all that are in the tombs shall hear his voice, and shall come forth, those that have done good, to the resurrection of life, and those that have done evil deeds, to the resurrection of judgment. I am not able of myself to do anything, but as I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, I seek not my own will, but the will of him that sent me. I bear witness of myself, and so my witness is not true. It is another that beareth witness of me, and I know that the witness which he beareth of me is true. Ye have sent unto John, and he hath borne witness of the truth. But not from man do I seek witness, but I say that ye may live. That was a lamp which shineth and giveth light, and ye were pleased to glory now in his light. But I have witness greater than that of John, the works which my Father hath given me to accomplish, those works which I do, bear witness of me, that the Father hath sent me. And the Father which sent me, he hath borne witness of me. Ye have neither heard his voice at any time, nor seen his appearance. And his word abideth not in you, because in him whom he hath sent ye do not believe. Search the Scriptures, in which ye rejoice that ye have eternal life, and they bear witness of me, and ye do not wish to come to me, that ye may have eternal life. I seek not praise of men. But I know you, that the love of God is not in you. I am come in the name of my Father, and ye received me not, but if another come in his own name, that one will ye receive. And how can ye believe, while ye receive praise one from another, and praise from God, the one, ye seek not? Can it be that ye think that I will accuse you before the Father? Ye have one that accuseth you, Moses, in whom ye have rejoiced. If ye believed Moses, ye would believe me also, Moses wrote of me. And if ye believed not his writings, how shall ye believe my words? Chapter 23. And Jesus departed thence, and came to the side of the Sea of Galilee, and went up into the mountain, and sat there. And there came unto him great multitudes, having with them lame, and blind, and dumb, and maimed, and many others, and they cast them at the feet of Jesus, for they had seen all the signs which he did in Jerusalem, when they were gathered at the feast. And he healed them all. And those multitudes marveled when they saw dumb men speak, and maimed men healed, and lame men walk, and blind men see, and they praised the God of Israel. And Jesus called his disciples, and said unto them, I have compassion on this multitude, because of their continuing with me 3 days, having nothing to eat, and to send them away fasting I am not willing, lest they faint in the way, some of them having come from far. His disciples said unto him, Whence have we in the desert bread wherewith to satisfy all this multitude? Jesus said unto them, How many loaves have ye? They said unto him, 7, and a few small fishes. And he commanded the multitudes to sit down upon the ground, and he took those 7 loaves and the fish, and blessed, and brake, and gave to his disciples to set before them, and the disciples set before the multitudes. And they all ate, and were satisfied, and they took that which remained over of the fragments, 7 basketfuls. And the people that ate were 4,000 men, besides the women and children. And when the multitudes departed, he went up into the boat, and came to the borders of Magadha. And the Pharisees and Sadducees came to him, and began to seek a discussion with him. And they asked him to shew them a sign from heaven, tempting him. And Jesus sighed within himself, and said, What sign seeketh this evil and adulterous generation? It seeketh a sign, and it shall not be given a sign, except the sign of Jonah the prophet. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not be given a sign. And he left them, and went up into the boat, and went away to that side. And his disciples forgot to take with them bread, and there was not with them in the boat even one loaf. And Jesus charged them, and said, Take heed, and guard yourselves from the leaven of the Pharisees and Sadducees, and from the leaven of Herod. And they reflected within themselves that they had taken with them no bread. And Jesus knew, and said unto them, Why think ye within yourselves, O ye of little faith, and are anxious, because ye have no bread? Until now do ye not perceive, neither understand? Is your heart yet hard? And have ye eyes, and yet see not? And have ye ears, and yet hear not? And do ye not remember when I break those 5 loaves for 5,000? And how many baskets full of broken pieces took ye up? They said, 12. He said unto them, And the 7 also for 4,000, how many baskets full of broken pieces took ye up? They said, 7. He said unto them, How have ye not understood that I spake not to you because of the bread, but that ye should beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and Sadducees? Then they understood that he spake, not that they should beware of the leaven of the bread, but of the doctrine of the Pharisees and Sadducees, which he called leaven. And after that, he came to Bethsaida. And they brought to him a certain blind man, and besought him that he would touch him. And he took the hand of that blind man, and led him out without the village, and spat in his eyes, and laid his hand on him, and asked him, What seest thou? And that blind man looked intently, and said unto him, I see men as trees walking. And he placed his hand again on his eyes, and they were restored, and he saw everything clearly. And he sent him to his house, and said, Do not enter even into the village, nor tell any man in the village. And Jesus went forth, and his disciples, to the villages of Caesarea Philippi. And while he was going in the way, and his disciples alone, he asked his disciples, and said, What do men say of me, that I am the Son of Man? They said unto him, Some say, John the Baptist, and others, Elijah, and others, Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. He said unto them, And ye, what say ye that I am? Simon Peter answered and said, Thou art the Messiah, the Son of the living God. Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed art thou, Simon son of Jonah, flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say unto thee also, that thou art Peter, and on this rock will I build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. To thee will I give the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. And he sternly charged his disciples, and warned them that they should not tell any man concerning him, that he was the Messiah. And henceforth began Jesus to shew to his disciples that he was determined to go to Jerusalem, and suffer much, and be rejected of the elders, and of the chief priests, and of the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day rise. And he was speaking plainly. And Simon Peter, as one grieved for him, said, Far be thou, my Lord, from that. And he turned, and looked upon his disciples, and rebuked Simon, and said, Get thee behind me, Satan, for thou art a stumbling block unto me, for thou thinkest not of what pertains to God, but of what pertains to men. And Jesus called the multitudes with his disciples, and said unto them, Whosoever would come after me, let him deny himself, and take his cross every day, and come after me. And whosoever would save his life shall lose it, and whosoever loseth his life for my sake, and for the sake of my gospel, shall save it. What shall a man profit, if he gain all the world, and destroy his own life, or lose it? Or what will a man give in ransom for his life? Whosoever shall deny me and my sayings in this sinful and adulterous generation, the Son of Man also will deny him, when he cometh in the glory of his Father with his holy angels. For the Son of Man is about to come in the glory of his Father with his holy angels, and then shall he reward each man according to his works. Chapter 24. And he said unto them, Verily I say unto you, there be here now some standing that shall not taste death, until they see the kingdom of God come with strength, and the Son of Man who cometh in his kingdom. And after 6 days Jesus took Simon Peter and James and John his brother, and brought them up into a high mountain, the three of them only. And while they were praying, Jesus changed and became after the fashion of another person, and his face shone like the sun, and his raiment was very white like the snow, and as the light of lightning, so that nothing on earth can whiten like it. And there appeared unto him Moses and Elijah talking to Jesus. And they thought that the time of his decease which was to be accomplished at Jerusalem was come. And Simon and those that were with him were heavy in the drowsiness of sleep, and with effort they roused themselves, and saw his glory, and those two men that were standing with him. And when they began to depart from him, Simon said unto Jesus, My master, it is good for us to be here, and if thou wilt, we will make here three tabernacles, one for thee, and one for Moses, and one for Elijah, not knowing what he said, because of the fear which took possession of them. And while he was yet saying that, a bright cloud overshadowed them. And when they saw Moses and Elijah that they had entered into that cloud, they feared again. And a voice was heard out of the cloud, saying, This is my beloved Son, whom I have chosen, hear ye therefore him. And when this voice was heard, Jesus was found alone. And the disciples, when they heard the voice, fell on their faces from the fear which took hold of them. And Jesus came and touched them and said, Arise, be not afraid. And they lifted up their eyes, and saw Jesus as he was. And when they went down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, and said unto them, Tell not what ye have seen to any man, until the Son of Man rise from among the dead. And they kept the word within themselves, and told no man in those days what they had seen. And they reflected among themselves, What is this word which he spake unto us, when I am risen from among the dead? And his disciples asked him, and said, What is that which the scribes say, then, that Elijah must first come? He said unto them, Elijah cometh first to set in order everything, and as it was written of the Son of Man, that he should suffer many things, and be rejected. But I say unto you, that Elijah is come, and they knew him not, and have done unto him whatsoever they desired, as it was written of him. In like manner the Son of Man is to suffer of them. Then understood the disciples that he spake unto them concerning John the Baptist. And on that day whereon they came down from the mountain, there met him a multitude of many people standing with his disciples, and the scribes were discussing with them. And the people, when they saw Jesus, were perplexed, and in the midst of their joy hastened and saluted him. And on that day came certain of the Pharisees, and said unto him, Get thee out, and go hence, for Herod seeketh to kill thee. Jesus said unto them, Go ye, and say to this fox, Behold, I am casting out demons, and I heal today and tomorrow, and on the third day I am perfected. Nevertheless I must be watchful a today and tomorrow, and on the last day I shall depart, for it cannot be that a prophet perish outside of Jerusalem. And after that, there came to him a man from that multitude, and fell upon his knees, and said unto him, I beseech thee, my Lord, look upon my son, he is my only child, and the Spirit cometh upon him suddenly. A lunacy hath come upon him, and he meeth with evils. And when it cometh upon him, it beateth him about, and he foameth, and gnasheth his teeth, and wasteth, and many times it hath thrown him into the water and into the fire to destroy him, and it hardly leaveth him after bruising him. And I brought him near to thy disciples, and they could not heal him. Jesus answered and said, O faithless and perverse generation, till when shall I be with you? And till when shall I bear with you? Bring thy son hither. And he brought him unto him, And when the Spirit saw him, immediately it beat him about, and he fell upon the ground, and was raging and foaming. And Jesus asked his father, How long is the time during which he hath been thus? He said unto him, From his youth until now. But, my Lord, help me wherein thou canst, and have mercy upon me. Jesus said unto him, If thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. And immediately the father of the child cried out, weeping, and said, I believe, my Lord, help my lack of faith. And when Jesus saw the hastening of the people, and their coming at the sound, he rebuked that unclean spirit, and said to it, Thou dumb spirit that speakest not, I command thee, come out of him, and enter not again into him. And that spirit, devil, cried out much, and bruised him, and came out, and that child fell as one dead, and many thought that he had died. But Jesus took him by his hand, and raised him up, and gave him to his father, and that child was healed from that hour. And the people all marveled at the greatness of God. And when Jesus entered into the house, his disciples came, and asked him privately, and said unto him, Why were we not able to heal him? Jesus said unto them, Because of your unbelief. Verily I say unto you, If ye have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall say to this mountain, Remove hence, and it shall remove, and nothing shall overcome you. But it is impossible to cast out this kind by anything except by fasting and prayer. And when he went forth thence, they passed through Galilee, and he would not that any man should know it. And he taught his disciples, and said unto them, Keep ye these sayings in your ears and your hearts, for the Son of Man is to be delivered into the hands of men, and they shall kill him, and when he is killed, he shall rise on the third day. But they knew not the word which he spake unto them, for it was concealed from them, that they should not perceive it, and they feared to ask him about this word. And they were exceeding sorrowful. Chapter 25. And in that day this thought presented itself to his disciples, and they said, Which haply should be the greatest among them? And when they came to Capernaum, and entered into the house, Jesus said unto them, What were ye considering in the way among yourselves? And they were silent because they had considered that matter. And when Simon went forth without, those that received 2 dirhams for the tribute came to Peter, and said unto him, Doth your master not give his 2 dirhams? He said unto them, Yea. And when Peter entered the house, Jesus anticipated him, and said unto him, What thinkest thou, Simon? The kings of the earth, from whom do they receive custom and tribute? From their sons, or from strangers? Simon said unto him, From strangers. Jesus said unto him, Children then are free. Simon said unto him, Yea. Jesus said unto him, Give thou also unto them, like the stranger. But, lest it trouble them, go thou to the sea, and cast a hook, and the first fish that cometh up, open its mouth, and thou shalt find a staler, take therefore that, and give for me and thee. And in that hour came the disciples to Jesus, and said unto him, Who, thinkest thou, is greater in the kingdom of heaven? And Jesus knew the thought of their heart, and called a child, and set him in the midst, and took him in his arms, and said unto them, Verily I say unto you, if ye do not return, and become as children, ye shall not enter the kingdom of heaven. Every one that shall receive in my name such as this child hath received me, and whosoever receiveth me receiveth not me, but him that sent me. And he who is little in your company, the same shall be great. But whosoever shall injure one of these little ones that believe in me, it were better for him that a great millstone should be hanged about his neck, and he should be drowned in the depths of the sea. John answered and said, Our master, we saw one casting out devils in thy name, and we prevented him, because he followed not thee with us. Jesus said unto them, Prevent him not, for no man doth powers in my name, and can hasten to speak evil of me. Every one who is not in opposition to you is with you. Woe unto the world because of trials. But woe unto that man by whose hand the trials come. If thy hand or thy foot injure thee, cut it off, and cast it from thee, For it is better for thee to enter into life being halt or maimed, and not that thou shouldest have two hands or two feet, and fall into the hell of fire that burneth forever, where their worm dieth not, and their fire is not quenched. And if thine eye seduce thee, pluck it out, and cast it from thee, for it is better for thee to enter the kingdom of God with one eye, than that thou shouldest have two eyes, and fall into the fire of Gehenna, where their worm dieth not, and their fire is not quenched. Every one shall be salted with fire, and every sacrifice shall be salted with salt. How good is salt? But if the salt also be tasteless, wherewith shall it be salted? It is fit neither for the land nor for dung, but they cast it out. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear. Have ye salt in yourselves and be in peace one with another. And he arose from thence, and came to the borders of Judea beyond Jordan, and there went unto him thither great multitudes, and he healed them, and he taught them also, according to his custom. And the Pharisees came unto him, tempting him, and asking him, Is it lawful for a man to put away his wife? He said, What did Moses command you? They said, Moses made it allowable for us, saying, Whosoever will, let him write a writing of divorcement, and put away his wife. Jesus answered and said unto them, Have ye not read, He that made them from the beginning made them male and female, and said, For this reason shall the man leave his father and his mother, and cleave to his wife, and they both shall be one body? So then they are not twain, but one body. The thing, then, which God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. And those Pharisees said unto him, Why did Moses consent that a man should give a writing of divorcement and put her away? Jesus said unto them, Moses because of the hardness of your hearts gave you leave to divorce your wives, but in the beginning it was not so. I say unto you, whosoever putteth away his wife without fornication, and marrieth another, hath exposed her to adultery. And his disciples, when he entered the house, asked him again about that. And he said unto them, Every one who putteth away his wife, and marrieth another, hath exposed her to adultery. And any woman that leaveth her husband, and becometh another's, hath committed adultery. And whosoever marrieth her that is divorced hath committed adultery. And his disciples said unto him, If there be between the man and the woman such a case as this, it is not good for a man to marry. He said unto them, Not every man can endure the saying, except him to whom it is given. There are eunuchs which from their mother's womb were born so, and there are eunuchs which through men became eunuchs, and there are eunuchs which made themselves eunuchs for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. He that is able to be content, let him be content. Then they brought to him children, that he should lay his hand upon them and pray, and his disciples were rebuking those that were bringing them. And Jesus saw, and it was distressing to him, and he said unto them, Suffer the children to come unto me, and prevent them not, for those that are like these have the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever receiveth not the kingdom of God as this child, shall not enter it. And he took them in his arms, and laid his hand upon them, and blessed them. Chapter 26. And there came unto him publicans and sinners to hear his word. And the scribes and the Pharisees murmured, and said, This man receiveth sinners, and eateth with them. And Jesus, when he beheld their murmuring, spake unto them this parable, What man of you, having 100 sheep, if one of them were lost, would not leave the 99 in the wilderness, and go and seek the straying one till he found it? Verily I say unto you, when he findeth it, he will rejoice over it more than over the 99 that went not astray, and bear it on his shoulders, and bring it to his house, and call his friends and neighbors, and say unto them, Rejoice with me, since I have found my straying sheep. So your Father which is in heaven willeth not that one of these little ones that have strayed should perish, and he seeketh for them repentance. I say unto you, thus there shall be rejoicing in heaven over one sinner that repenteth, more than over 99 righteous persons that do not need repentance. And what woman having 10 drachmas would lose one of them, and not light a lamp, and sweep the house, and seek it with care till she found it, and when she found it, call her friends and neighbors, and say unto them, Rejoice with me, as I have found my drachma that was lost. I say unto you, thus there shall be joy before the angels of God over the one sinner that repenteth, more than over the 99 righteous persons that do not need repentance. And Jesus spoke unto them also another parable, A man had two sons, and the younger son said unto him, My father, give me my portion that belongeth to me of thy goods. And he divided between them his property. And after a few days the younger son gathered everything that belonged to him, and went into a far country, and there squandered his property by living prodigally. And when he had exhausted everything he had, there occurred a great dearth in that country. And when he was in want, he went and joined himself to one of the people of a city of that country, and that man sent him into the field to feed the swine. And he used to long to fill his belly with the carob that those swine were eating, and no man gave him. And when he returned unto himself, he said, How many hired servants now in my father's house have bread enough and to spare, while I here perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father's house, and say unto him, My father, I have sinned in heaven and before thee, and am not worthy now to be called thy son, make me as one of thy hired servants. And he arose, and came to his father. But his father saw him while he was at a distance, and was moved with compassion for him, and ran, and fell on his breast, and kissed him. And his son said unto him, My father, I have sinned in heaven and before thee, and am not worthy to be called thy son. His father said unto his servants, Bring forth a stately robe, and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand, and put on him shoes on his feet, and bring and slay a fat ox, that we may eat and make merry, for this my son was dead, and is alive, and was lost, and is found. And they began to be merry. Now his elder son was in the field, and when he came and drew near to the house, he heard the sound of many singing. And he called one of the lads, and asked him what this was. He said unto him, Thy brother hath arrived, and thy father hath slain a fat ox, since he hath received him safe and sound. And he was angry, and would not enter, so his father went out, and besought him to enter. And he said to his father, How many years do I serve thee in bondage, and I never transgressed a commandment of thine, and thou hast never given me a kid, that I might make merry with my friends. But this thy son, when he had squandered thy property with harlots, and come, thou hast slain for him a fat ox. His father said unto him, My son, thou art at all times with me, and everything I have is thine. It behoveth thee to rejoice and make merry, since this thy brother was dead, and is alive, and was lost, and is found. And he spake a parable unto his disciples, There was a rich man, and he had a steward, and he was accused to him that he had squandered his property. So his lord called him, and said unto him, What is this that I hear regarding thee? Give me the account of thy stewardship, for it is now impossible that thou shouldest be a steward for me. The steward said within himself, What shall I do, seeing that my lord taketh from me the stewardship? To dig I am not able, and to beg I am ashamed. I know what I will do, that, when I go out of the stewardship, they may receive me into their houses. And he called one after another of his lord's debtors, and said to the first, How much owest thou my lord? He said unto him, 100 portions of oil. He said unto him, Take thy writing, and sit down, and write quickly 50 portions. And he said to the next, And thou, how much owest thou my lord? He said unto him, 100 cores of wheat. He said unto him, Take thy writing, and sit down, and write 80 cores. And our Lord commended the sinful steward because he had done a wise deed, for the children of this world are wiser than the children of the light in this their age. And I also say unto you, Make unto yourselves friends with the wealth of this unrighteousness, so that, when it is exhausted, they may receive you into their tents forever. He who is faithful in a little is faithful also in much, and he who is unrighteous in a little is unrighteous also in much. If then in the wealth of unrighteousness ye were not trustworthy, who will entrust you with the truth? If ye are not found faithful in what does not belong to you, who will give you what belongeth to you? Chapter 27. Therefore the kingdom of heaven is like a certain king, who would make a reckoning with his servants. And when he began to make it, they brought to him one who owed him 10 talents. And because he had not wherewith to pay, his lord ordered that he should be sold, he, and his wife, and children, and all that he had, and payment be made. So that servant fell down and worshipped him, and said unto him, My lord, have patience with me, and I shall pay thee everything. And the lord of that servant had compassion, and released him, and forgave him his debt. And that servant went out, and found one of his fellow servants, who owed him 100 pence, and he took him, and dealt severely with him, and said unto him, Give me what thou owest. So the fellow servant fell down at his feet, and besought him, and said, Grant me respite, and I will pay thee. And he would not, but took him, and cast him into prison, till he should give him his debt. And when their fellow servants saw what happened, it distressed them much, and they came and told their lord of all that had taken place. Then his lord called him, and said unto him, Thou wicked servant, all that debt I forgave thee, because thou besoughtest me, was it not then incumbent on thee also to have mercy on thy fellow servant, as I had mercy on thee? And his lord became wroth, and delivered him to the scourgers, till he should pay all that he owed. So shall my Father which is in heaven do unto you, if one forgive not his brother his wrong conduct from his heart. Take heed within yourselves, if thy brother sin, rebuke him, and if he repent, forgive him. And if he act wrongly towards thee 7 times in a day, and on that day return 7 times unto thee, and say, I repent towards thee, forgive him. And if thy brother act wrongly towards thee, go and reprove him between thee and him alone, if he hear thee, thou hast gained thy brother. But if he hear thee not, take with thee 1 or 2, and so at the mouth of 2 or 3 every saying shall be established. And if he listen not to these also, tell the congregation, and if he listen not even to the congregation, let him be unto thee as a publican and a Gentile. Verily I say unto you, all that ye bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and what ye loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. I say unto you also, if 2 of you agree on earth to ask, everything shall be granted them from my Father which is in heaven. For where 2 or 3 are gathered in my name, there am I amongst them. Then Peter drew near to him, and said unto him, My Lord, how many times, if my brother act wrongly towards me, should I forgive him? Until 7 times. Jesus said unto him, I say not unto thee, until 7, but, until 70 times 7, 7. And the servant that knoweth his Lord's will, and maketh not ready for him according to his will, shall meet with much punishment, but he that knoweth not, and doth something for which he meriteth punishment, shall meet with slight punishment. Every one to whom much hath been given, much shall be asked of him, and he that hath had much committed to him, much shall be required at his hand. I came to cast fire upon the earth, and I would that it had been kindled already. And I have a baptism to be baptized with, and greatly am I straitened till it be accomplished. See that ye despise not one of these little ones that believe in me. Verily I say unto you, their angels at all times see the face of my Father which is in heaven. The Son of Man came to save the thing which was lost. And after that, Jesus walked in Galilee, and he did not like to walk in Judea, because the Jews sought to kill him. And there came people who told him of the Galileans, those whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. Jesus answered and said unto them, Do ye imagine that those Galileans were sinners more than all the Galileans, so that this thing has come upon them? Nay. Verily I say unto you now, that ye shall all also, if ye repent not, likewise perish. Or perchance those 18 on whom the palace fell in Siloam, and slew them, do ye imagine that they were to be condemned more than all the people that dwell in Jerusalem? Nay. Verily I say unto you, if ye do not all repent, ye shall perish like them. And he spake unto them this parable, A man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, And he came and sought fruit thereon, and found none. So he said to the husbandman, Lo, 3 years do I come and seek fruit on this fig tree, and find none, cut it down, why doth it render the ground unoccupied? The husbandman said unto him, My lord, leave it this year also, that I may dig about it, and dung it, then if it bear fruit. And if not, then cut it down in the coming year. And when Jesus was teaching on the Sabbath day in one of the synagogues, there was there a woman that had a spirit of disease 18 years, and she was bowed down, and could not straighten herself at all. And Jesus saw her, and called her, and said unto her, Woman, be loosed from thy disease. And he put his hand upon her, and immediately she was straightened, and praised God. And the chief of the synagogue answered with anger, because Jesus had healed on a Sabbath, and said unto the multitudes, There are 6 days in which work ought to be done, come in them and be healed, and not on the Sabbath day. But Jesus answered and said unto him, Ye hypocrites, doth not each of you on the Sabbath day loose his ox or his ass from the manger, and go and water it? Ought not this woman, who is a daughter of Abraham, and whom the devil hath bound 18 years, to be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day? And when he said this, they were all put to shame, those standing, who were opposing him, and all the people were pleased with all the wonders that proceeded from his hand.